Hello students, in today's video we want to read about the composition of blood. Well, blood, it is basically composed of two components. One is plasma and the other is cellular elements. We'll read about plasma first. Plasma is the fluid part of the blood which constitutes around 55 to 60% of blood. It is light yellow in color and it is an alkaline fluid. It is composed of these different substances. It has water around 90 to 92%, proteins around 7 to 8%, inorganic salts around 1%, and other substances in traces. Well, these inorganic salts, they include sodium chloride and sodium bicarbonate, and the other substances include glucose, amino acids, fibrinogen, hormones, and urea. Well, if from this plasma, this fibrinogen protein is removed, all other substances are there, but this fibrinogen, if we remove it, then it is known as serum. So, if you get a define of serum, it is the plasma from which protein fibrinogen has been removed. You remember this term, fibrinogen protein is removed from the plasma, it forms serum. You can have this question as fill in the blanks or name the following. Name the protein which is removed and the plasma turns to serum. We have to write fibrinogen. What do we call the plasma from which protein fibrinogen has been removed? So, the answer will be serum. Then the other component, the second component of blood, the cellular elements. Now these cellular elements, they are of further three types. RBC means red blood cells, WBCs means white blood cells, and blood platelets. We will discuss all of them one by one. In today's video, we will learn about the RBCs. Well, RBCs, they are also known as erythrocytes. They are very small, minute in size. They are biconcave disc-like structures that are flat in the center and thick and rounded at periphery. Okay, see, this is the structure. They are biconcave, means this side is curved inside and this side is curved inside. The periphery is rounded and thick. So this small size plus these concavities, they provide a large surface area which makes these RBC is more efficient for absorbing oxygen. We know that oxygen is absorbed by RBCs. So their small size and these two concavities, they, as they increase the surface area, so the absorption of oxygen will be increased. The small size of RBCs, that also enable them to travel through very fine capillaries. The small size of the RBCs, it helps the RBCs to travel through the very fine capillaries so that it can provide oxygen to every part of the organ of the cell. Now, where they are produced? In adults, we are talking about the production of RBCs. In adults, the RBCs, the red blood cells, they are produced in the marrow of long bones. Long bones, that means bones that are specially in the ribs, our breastbone, and ileum of the hip girdle. Then if we talk about in embryo, where the production of these RBCs takes place? In embryo, liver and spleen, these are the two organs where the production of RBCs takes place. You have to learn it. You can have this question in your exam. The production of RBCs in embryo took place in dash. So that time you have to enter liver and spleen. Now if we talk about children, in bone marrow of all bones until 5 years of age. So up to this 5 years of age, in all the bones, all the bone marrows, the RBCs, they are produced. And in adults, it just then ceases to the bone marrows of the long bones, as we have discussed earlier. Now we talk about the characteristics of blood. Well, no nucleus in mature RBCs. When the RBCs are produced, they do have a nucleus, but when they mature, they lost it. Average lifespan of RBCs is around 120 days. And once they are destroyed or they are infected or they get weakened, they are destroyed in spleen, liver and bone marrow. Now, when the RBCs, they are destroyed, the iron containing part, it is retained in the liver, and the protein part, it is excreted as a bile pigment, bilirubin. We have discussed this bilirubin in our excretory system also. Now, important component of RBCs is hemoglobin, which is also known as respiratory pigment. In hemoglobin, this heme part, it is the iron part. Hemin, it is we call it hemin, and the protein part is this globin. Globin is the protein part of hemoglobin, and now we know that hemoglobin, it combines with oxygen to form an unstable compound which is known as oxyhemoglobin. It then goes to the tissues and where they dissociate to give the oxygen to the tissues. Now this hemoglobin, it has a very strong affinity with carbon monoxide, and with this it forms a stable compound which is known as carboxyhemoglobin. See, when it combines with oxygen, it forms an unstable compound, but with carbon monoxide, it forms a stable compound, carboxyhemoglobin. What happens when this carboxyhemoglobin compound is formed? This cuts down the oxygen carrying capacity of blood, leading to death by carbon monoxide poisoning. You have read this in your junior classes also. Now, what are the different disorders related with these RBCs? When the number of RBCs is increased, the condition is known as polycythemia, and when the number of RBCs decreases in your blood, the condition is known as erythropenia. So this is all about the RBCs. Next video we'll do about the WBCs. Thank you.